Oregon State Representative Mike Nierman caught on surveillance video letting armed protesters into the state capitol back in December. This was during a special session. All of our lawmakers were there inside the building at the time, and according to several who I spoke to, they were told not to open the doors for this very reason. We also have some video from outside of the state capitol after Nierman opens the door there. A rush of protesters run around the corner and try to get inside. You can then see Nierman on the steps chatting with some of the protesters, and he too eventually goes back inside. Now, he's been getting in trouble for this, lots of trouble, but he still has his job. See, House Speaker Tina Kotek can't fire him from this. She did strip him of his committee assignments, and she fined him $2,000, but that's about as far as her powers can go. But that's not good enough for some people who want him gone entirely. 24 leaders from groups like Basic Rights Oregon, the NAACP, the Western State Center, they all signed on to the letter we have on your screen right now calling for the State House to expel him. This is possible, but it requires a two-thirds majority vote, which means 40 lawmakers. And right now there are 37 Democrats, so they would all need to vote for this, and some Republicans. But the people signing this letter are saying that this really shouldn't be a partisan issue.
This isn't about politics or partisanship. It's about the future of our democracy. The legislature needs to send a clear message that violence is never acceptable and that those who encourage and enable it have no place in the lawmaking process. Lawmakers are now going to work every day with someone in their midst who appears to have conspired with violent actors who tried to smash down doors to gain entry and assaulted journalists after Representative Nierman opened that door for them. No one who watches the security footage can believe he deserves to hold office and represent Oregonians.
So it's unclear how lawmakers as a whole feel about all of this or a vote, but we can kind of guess one location or one group of people that might be happy with him gone, and that's his kind of hometown of Independence. And I say kind of because even though Nierman has an Independence address, he really lives outside of town, which is something the town's been very specific to let us know about. They've been trying to distance themselves from him since the story first broke. They actually sent out a press release to remind everyone that Nierman doesn't technically represent them. And then we get this from the mayor. He told OPB, because of Nierman, we've had people that have lost business. We've had people who have canceled reservations. We have people who said, we were going to come visit your community, but we're not going to because of the actions of that person. Now, I don't know if all that is exactly true. I didn't call around to businesses down there. I will say personally, I rely a little more on Yelp reviews to make a choice on a restaurant than its vicinity to Mike Nierman, but that is quite a quote to get from the town's mayor. Nierman says, you know, through all of this, he's spoken a few times, he doesn't condone or participate in violence, and that he and his family have been threatened over this, which is just awful. And if anybody is doing that, they should stop immediately. That's a terrible thing to do. He's also lashing out, though, at House Speaker Kotek, saying this is all a political attack on him. The man who was caught on camera opening the doors to the Capitol, letting in a violent mob. After being told not to open the doors to the Capitol because of the violent mob trying to get in, it kind of sounds a little bit more like simple math than complex politics, but it's a bold strategy, Cotton. Let's see if it pays off for him.